Deltarune Chapters 1 and 2 feature a massive soundtrack, smooth and expressive pixel animation, creative bullet-dodging based battles, and of course, only one ending. How is that for a selling point? After the multiple endings of Toby Fox's previous game Undertale and the plethora of games touting player choice, Toby Fox proclaiming Deltarune has only one ending truly does set it apart. However, this single ending serves a greater purpose within Deltarune. Whereas in Undertale, every action the player took influenced the ending of the game, in Deltarune, nothing does. In Undertale, you can't even turn the game off or kill a single enemy without influencing the ending. I wouldn't be surprised if it was watching me while I slept to see if I had any murderous dreams. Player choice is now simply flavor text in Deltarune, and kind or not so kind choices can be chosen freely without influencing the end. Chris, the player character, is truly neutral throughout the game. Their sprite never shows emotion, even while Susie and Railsy show a wide range of expressions. The two act as the sort of angel and devil on Chris's shoulder, leading them to either spare or fight their enemies. But again, these choices don't matter. In Chapter 2, Noelle and Birdly join the gang in the New Dark World. Towards the end, Susie tells a story to Noelle about when they first met, and Noelle gave Susie a pencil when she needed one, a simple act of kindness. Deltarune's advertised linear story with a single ending allows the player to make the kind choice to spare foes, compliment Railsy, give a gift, for no other reason than it is the kind thing to do. There is no capital T, capital E, true ending to unlock. Undertale is a game where every decision has consequences, and someone is always watching, keeping tally and waiting to pass judgment. Deltarune is a game about who you are when you know no one is watching.